according to his likeness. After creating the universe, he found its good and realized its incompleteness. He planned to create a human being to complete its incompleteness. He made man out of mud, who is an image and likeness of God. He found that man can't live alone, so he created woman from man. That's why we call her woman, who came from man. After completing his creation, God was happy. He gave all the authority, power to human over his creation.
But now, the human life is just the opposite. For example, violence against the race and greed, addiction of the new generation, broken families.
God saw the condition of the whole world from heaven. He said to himself, I made everything for good. Finally, I made human beings for a particular purpose, but now they have forgotten my purpose and choose their own purposes. They try to find their own happiness.
God was so unhappy to see his children going away from the just path. Since God so loved the world, he didn't want to abandon us. Even though time to time God saved the human race through numerous people, at the end he was ready to send his beloved son to redeem us from the sinful life and to destroy the works of the devil. We are waiting for his coming as we are longing to see his presence in us and among us. John chapter 3 verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. This is the fulfillment of God's plan for us. Let's watch the fulfillment of God's promises through the enactment.
Thank you. Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin named Mary, who was pledged to be married to a carpenter named Joseph.
Greeting, Mary, you are highly favored, and the Lord is with you.
What do you want? Why have you come to see me?
Do not be afraid. You have found favor with God, and you will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will call him Jesus.
How is that possible? I am a virgin.
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
I serve the Lord. May His will be done.
Joseph, Mary's betrothed, found out Mary was pregnant before they came together because he loved her. Yet, believed she had been unfaithful, he decided to divorce her quietly so she would not be in disgrace. But before he could, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream.
Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. Her child was conceived from the Holy Spirit, and you are to call him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sin.
Find Mary and make her my wife.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken by the entire Roman world. Everyone was required to go to their hometown to register.
Listen! 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 Attention, everyone! The Emperor Caesar Augustus wants to know how many of you are living in this land. So, everyone must go to the town where they are born to be counted. If any one of you disobey the Empire, you will be punished.
So Joseph took Mary, who was great with child, on the hard journey to Bethlehem to register.
Thank you.
Oh Mary, I wish we didn't have to go to Bethlehem. Especially now when you are expecting a baby. I'm so worried about you.
Don't worry, Joseph. Everything will work out fine. God will look after us.
When Mary and Joseph arrived, they looked for a place to stay.
We don't have place. Go away from here.
Who are you? What do you want?
My wife is about to give birth. We need a place to stay. We have a lost hope. My wife cannot stay in a cold.
There is no room left. Can you see how crowded the city is? Oh, there is no place for you here. Please help us. I need a warm place to have my child.
But there is a stable nearby. You can stay there. It is not that much, but it will give you some shelter to live.
How can a son of God be born in a dirty stable?
It's okay, Mary. God will provide. You and the baby will be out of the cold.
Come, we will show you.
For the baby to be born. Mary gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
I will name him Jesus, just as the angel instructed me.
He is promised Messiah, the Son of God.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
I bring you good news that will cause great joy today in the town of David. A Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be the sign. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth lying there in a manger.
What? The Messiah we have waited for has come.
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." And the baby who lay in the manger.
Beautiful, no?
Yes.
bless you.
Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east. The wise men are here.
Rose and have come to worship him.
King Herod heard about the wise men and the baby over the place where the child was. They saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him.
Let us not give up. Hope it can be not too much farther. Now the star is getting lower in the sky. We are getting closer. Now come on. Come, let us go.
I'm sure that baby Jesus is very happy with
your gift. Thank you. May God bless you and keep you safe on your journeys.
King Herod asks us to return to him to let him know where the child is. But we were warned in a dream not to go back to him. We will return to our country by another route. Yes, yes.
Christmas, the first Christmas, after the wise man had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and told him to escape to Egypt. There, the Holy Family lived until King Herod was dead, and then they went to live in a town called Nazareth. Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and men. He was the Son of God, born to save his people by bearing their sins. Christmas fills our hearts with joy as we think of gifts, lights, and holiday spirit. And remember, Christmas means something more. It's birth of our Savior Jesus Christ. Baby Jesus brings the light of love in the world, the love that touches each one of us.
Thank you. Thank you.